Good afternoon and welcome to this webinar from Mulcal International. My name is Miriam Rickley and I will explain today a little bit more about the Multicolor Slim, our universal fire color. The webinar will take approximately 30 minutes. Here you can see the full portfolio of all our Mulcal fire stopping products, ranging from bandages and the multi-disc to the coated board, which is called our Multimastic C system, the acrylic sealants that we have, the graphite. But today I will be talking about the Multicolor Slim, which of course has been tested with our other products in the portfolio. So first I will explain a little bit more about the characteristics of the Multicolor Slim, the installation and the usage as well. And then I will explain more about the tested configurations that we have. I'll give also some examples of tested solutions and some new tested applications that we actually have done very recently. So the Universal Fire Multicolor Slim is a universal fire color. It's one color that can have a multitude of applications and diameters. So it's ideal for lots of different applications. And with a very limited height of only 30 millimeters, it's ideal to use in congested spaces as well. So the color comes in a roll length of 2.6 meters and exists of 174 segments. So this 2.6 meters makes sure that you can have exactly six pipe colors for pipes of 110 millimeter diameter. So I explained already the color has got 174 segments. It also comes in a box with the fixings for different, these are the same fixings for different substrates and the multi-clips to fix actually your color to the wall. So you've got everything in one box ready to start installing it. We've also tested the Multicolor Slim with our coated board system, the Multimastic C system. And for this, we have got our multi-screw FB for fireboard, that is, which is a lot easier than, for example, threaded rods and nuts and bolts. So it's just the multi-screw FB, which is a lot easier to install as well and makes it a lot quicker installation process. Because it's only 30 millimeter height, you can even get sometimes underneath a pipe to install the color around it. But even where it's not possible, we've got applications where you can actually have a horseshoe shape, but I will go into that a lot more in a few minutes. We have tested our Multicolor Slim up to 120 minutes. And you can find also the conformity statements in the box, which you can just paste next to the penetration seal. Here is a nice little example, a nice little picture of different examples of the Multicolor Slim. As I mentioned, it can be used for just plain pipe penetration straight to the wall, but also, for example, when you've got at the left-hand side pipes going at an angle through the wall, it doesn't necessarily have the angle going up. It can also be sideways at that angle. And for example, pipes with an elastomeric insulation, like metal pipes with an elastomeric insulation, or even multi-layer pipes, like aluminium multi-layer pipes. And just in the corner, you can see pipes where you actually physically can't put a full color around it. We still have tests for these kinds of applications. So you can see there's a lot of options with the Multicolor Slim for all sorts of different applications. Also at the foreground, you see actually different types of surfaces, different types of pipes, and even some cables. And they all pass through the same penetration opening with one Multicolor Slim around it. We've got various options in this kind of configuration. And so if you need any information on this, please contact myself or Mulcal afterwards for more details. By the way, if you have any questions, feel free to put them in the chat. I will look at them after the webinar, and if we haven't got enough time, I will come back to you personally after the webinar as well for this. On installing the Multicolor Slim, if you have, for example, a wall made out of concrete or blockwork, you can use the multi-screw that is added in the box of the Multicolor Slim. You will, because of the hard surface, you will need to pre-drill a hole of 6 millimeters only, even though the screw is slightly bigger. This is for the screw to bite, and that's the multicolor fixed with the multi-clips to the wall. As I mentioned before, this screw is also suitable for different substrates. So again, the same multi-screw you can use for aerated concrete or plasterboard walls as well. However, then you do not need to pre-drill a hole. It's important to have the right settings just to make sure that you don't overdrive the fixings so they start spinning around in their own hole opening. The same for floors. You can use the same multi-screw for floors as well, concrete floors. Now, if you have a coated board system, we've got our multi-screw FB, which is like the little pigtail screws that you can use. They are 40 millimeters long as well. The usage of the pipes, you can see you can use the multicolor slim from tiny little pipes of 16 millimeters all the way up to pipes that are 315 millimeters. And this table you can find as well at the back of the box as well and in the technical data sheet, et cetera, et cetera. So I'll give you just an example. For example, a 110 millimeter pipe would need 29 segments, and you will need 3 multi-clips to fix actually the multicolor to the wall, which means you can have exactly 6 multicolor slims for 110 millimeter out of one roll or out of one box. If you look at a really big diameter pipe, 315 millimeter, you will need 72 segments to go around the pipe, but because of the massive diameter of this pipe, you will need 2 colors on top of each other. And the first line you will only need to fix with 2 clips. The second one, the large multi-clips, will actually hold the first one in place as well. So you need 6 of them. And therefore you can only have 2 of these pipe colors from one roll. Now, I can hear you thinking already, I've got 30 segments left. Don't worry, you can reuse them on the next roll. I'll explain that in a minute as well. But here you can see, for example, if you have, for example, a pipe between 160 and 200 millimeters, you need just one multi-clip, which is actually to just join the multicolor together again to make it into a round multicolor. And it's probably very difficult to see, but you don't even need to mechanically fix this to the wall. And then the large multi-clips, the Bs, the blue ones, you need 4 of them, and they will hold automatically the first color in place as well. So these are fixed to the wall and they hold also the first place. So you've got then only a 60 millimeter, which is still a very low height for your colors. So as I mentioned, you might have segments left after you've used most of your multicolor slim, and you are allowed to reuse them into another color. You can only use a maximum of 2-3 parts of the multicolor slim for a new color, as you can see here in different colors, light gray, dark gray, and blue. And it is possible then that you might need an additional clip to join all these 3 pieces together with each other, which is perfectly fine. You are allowed to use more clips than is recommended. Now, I often get a question. I seem to have a bit of a gap between the pipe and the multicolor. That's absolutely no problem at all. We have tested this for pipes up to 125 millimeter. You are allowed 15 millimeter space between the pipe and the multicolor slim. So that's the little A. However, if the pipe becomes bigger than 125 millimeter, this space is reduced to 5 millimeter. So it's the red area that's 5 millimeter for large pipes and 15 millimeter for pipes under 125 millimeter diameter. Of course, you will need to seal between the pipe and the substrate. That could be either plasterboard or concrete. And if the joint is smaller than 20 millimeter, we can use either multi-sealant A or multi-mastic SP. Both are perfectly fine to use for gaps up to 20 millimeter. However, if the gap is larger, that's between the pipe and the substrate, like the plasterboard wall or the floor, then you can use multi-mortar. Or if it's really a lot bigger, then you might want to use a coated board, because we also have tested our colors with our coated board, the Multimastic C system. Now, we are constantly retesting our Multicolor Slim and other products to make sure that we have covered most or every application that you can find on site, but also to make sure that we have reduced distances between the surfaces, for example. Here, for example, in our coated board, the Multimastic C system, we have now reduced distances between pipe colors. As you can see, it's now on the left-hand corner at the bottom, it's now 0 millimeters, which is the A4. And if you have it between a pipe collar and a insulation around a metal pipe, for example, it is 50 millimeters. So we try to reduce these distances because it will make it easier for yourselves on site. You will find applications on site that aren't quite as we tested it. So we keep on testing them to make sure that they meet your requirements. Of course, if you have any questions about this, please contact me afterwards. That's no problem. Now, I mentioned earlier, we've got like the Multicolor Slim tested in different types of configurations. And this is, for example, where you've got a shelf or a shell, which is like a metal shell, and a plastic pipe lays in it, which is especially used for hot fluids. Because the pipe might start sagging, and so this is actually to support it. We've tested these up to 90 millimeters. Larger pipes up to 110 millimeters, we have tested for different applications again. So these are the more standard vented waste pipes, etc. Like elbow pipes, either 2x45 degrees or 1x90 degrees. And you can actually see in this diagram, it's just not possible to put a full collar around these pipes. So we have tested the horseshoe application, which you put around the pipes, and that will work. I will come into the detail of that a little bit later. But also pipes that are actually very close to the floor, or even very tight into a corner, as you can see here. So that's for the wall applications. Similar for floor applications, we've tested pipes up to 110 millimeters, where they go at an angle, or again, where you've got like elbow pipes and the joints of elbow pipes. Larger pipes, we've even tested in walls with an angle. So in the floor, it was 110 millimeter. In the wall, it's up to 125 millimeter. So it's at an angle. Or where you've got different couplings, for example, electrofusion couplings. I've got an example of that in a few minutes as well. Again, elbow pipes, but in this case, you can actually go around the pipe completely. And for floor applications, sorry about that. We've got couplings, again, like electrofusion couplings, or where they are tied in a corner. Now, the really large pipes we've tested just straight through a wall or straight through a floor. And so we've tested PVC pipes up to 315 millimeter diameter. Now, we've also tested multiple penetrations. This is where I showed earlier in the picture, where you've got like different types of pipes and maybe even some cables in as well through one opening, and you seal them with one Multicolor Slim around them. It's very difficult to explain all the scenarios we have, and I would recommend that you have a look on our multi-selector. This is a digital tool on the website and on any of the mobile devices with an app, where you can click on the application that you've got and the services that you've got, how they go through a partition or through a wall, and then the tested solution will come up, including a link to the test report and a link to the details as well, or it's actually giving you the details as well. So that's called a multi-selector, where you can find all these applications. I will now go a little bit deeper into some of the examples. Oh, before I do that, I will need to explain about the use of the pipe. If a pipe, for example, is going to be used with an open system, like a rainwater pipe or a vented wastewater pipe, which is actually open to the elements, it might be you will have like air coming in, and once there's a fire, the air will also want to get out of the room with the fire, or the, in this case, the furnace, because there's an overpressure in the furnace. So air will go out and create like an overpressure on the seal it wants to create. Now, this is tested as uncapped, uncapped on both sides. And that is mainly for rainwater pipes and vented waste pipes that are open to the outside. However, if you've got like a closed system, which we test as uncapped, capped, the air might want to go out, but it can't really go out because it's like a closed system. So it's got really nowhere to go. So that is for combustible pipes, for example, for gas or heating, water supply, etc. And that is tested uncapped, capped. For metal pipes, metal won't melt in a normal standard indoor fire. And so it will stay in place. So the smoke can't even get into the fire. So that's tested as a closed system inside the furnace and then open on the outside. And we've got closed as last one, which is, for example, a decommissioned pipe. It's closed on both sides. Now, I explained already, like the uncapped, uncapped scenario is actually the worst case scenario because it creates a large pressure on top on the seal that's been created by a collar, for example. So you can use that for uncapped, capped, but you can't do it the other way around, because that might actually mean in real life situations that your seal will actually break because of the overpressure in the room where the fire is. So here I've got just a nice slide with lots of different pictures of the applications, what we can do with a multicolor slim, for example. One of them is, for example, aluminium multi-layer pipes, and they can be in different applications as well, like very close to the floor. Or we got here an elbow pipe. So here's a really good like picture of an elbow pipe. We've tested these in walls, but also in floors, as you can see here. And of course, we've tested a lot of configurations with our coated board system for straight pipes up to 110 millimeter diameter in coated boards. We've also tested shaft hole situations where you've got flue gas pipes, and they've tested 90 minutes for fire to the inside of the shaft. And for example, as I mentioned earlier, where it's very close to a corner or very close to the floor where you physically can't put a full collar around. So this is just a little overview of different applications. So plastic pipes up to 160 minutes, just with a plain, simple, single multicolor slim, you can achieve up to 2 hours fire rating. Tested through partitions, and that means also it's automatically fine for rigid walls as well, but also for floors. You can see as well, like for walls, you need the collar on both sides of the walls because you're not quite sure where the fire might come from. So you will need a collar on both sides of the wall. But for a floor, the fire is always from underneath. So you have the collar to the underside of the wall. You can also see here that it's tested with like an acoustic insulation around the pipe as well. If we go to the larger pipes between 160 and 315 millimeter, then you can see that we will need two collars in order to create a good seal for your fire rating. That still has a fire rating up to 2 hours as well. And again, you see it like the floor just underneath, and for the wall on both sides of the wall, you need the two collars. Multi-layer pipes we've tested as well, up to 110 millimeters, and we've tested them with elastomeric insulation as well. And just a single multicolor slim will be able to achieve up to 120 minutes. Now, we've got a lot of composite and multi-layer pipes. You can see like some of the manufacturers on the left of it, and some on the pictures on the right, giving you like a bit of an idea of applications that we've got with it, like with PE insulation as well. but also in coated board or when it's close to the floor as well. So all types of different applications we've tested with these as well. And if you want to know more about these, you can contact Molcol or you can look on the multi-selector for applications that you might be dealing with at the moment. Now, corner solutions, as you can see here, you won't be able to fit a collar physically all the way around it. Just with a single multicolor slim, you can actually, we have tested this up to 90 minutes, also again for floor and for wall applications. Just something to pay attention to is that you have maximum 2 segments at the end of the clip. And of course, the wall at the side and the floor need to be able to withstand the same fire rating as well. With an elbow pipe, again, we've tested that, so you need to pay attention that you have like adding 15 segments to the collar length. So if you normally have like 29 segments for 110 millimeter pipe, you now need 44 segments for the collar. So you add it to the collar. So in a picture, you can see here that it's like a horseshoe, well, quite a long horseshoe shape. And maximum of 15 clips between the band, between the two, 15 segments between the two clips. And also very important is that you fold over the end of the metal of the collar. This way, the graphite inlay that will start expanding doesn't expand into the mid-air, but it expands towards the opening that you want to close off. So here we can see an example of the electrofusion joint. And you can see like the little nips, but I've got another picture as well in the corner where you can see the nips a little bit better. Sometimes people have tried to take these nips off because the color is not really working very well. With the multicolor slim, we have tested it with the nips still on, so you don't need to break anything off. Neither. We've tested 60 minutes for 125 millimeter pipe and 120 minutes for 110. So it's like these electrofusion couplings, for example, as like one of the coupling elements. Through the coated board system, again, we've got like various solutions that you can use. Just standard PVC pipes up to 110 millimeters, fiber composite up to 50 millimeters. I'm just giving you a few pictures for you to take in. This is quite interesting. Here you can see again that we've got actually two pipes together through one opening in a coated board with one single multicolor on each side of it. So you don't have to separate them. They can be actually combined into one color. So it saves you time and money on site as well. You can see as well the pigtails, the screws for the coated boards that we have for our Multimastic C system. And it's like a double Multimastic C system. Also quite interesting is with our Multimastic C system, we have this tested without lining the opening as well, just in case you might come across that scenario. In the floor, very similar as well. You can see the pigtails as well. The 40 millimeter just sticking slightly short of the 50 millimeter board. Now, I mentioned we're constantly testing new solutions, and this is a screenshot from our multi-selector where you actually just click on any of these applications that you might have on site, like PVC pipe or PE pipe, etc., etc. And you will always find new in blue around with the new penetrations that we have tested. This can be new surfaces, but it's also, for example, new types of partitions. Like we've tested recently a very slim partition with a single layer of plasterboard as well. So that's all, it always gives you just like a bit of a reminder, like, okay, we've tested something new again. So one of these new ones are, for example, this inclined pipe at an angle, maximum 45 degrees, because otherwise you can imagine if it's very shallow to the wall, the area becomes extremely large. And previously we had tested this just straight through a plasterboard partition, but now we've tested it on coated board as well. And because you can use the pigtail screws, and you don't need to use rods or anything like that. It's very easy to install on the coated board as well. Another solution that's very newly tested only a few months ago is the HDPE pipe up to 250 millimeter. So that's a lot larger than what we have tested before. Just because you all mentioned that there's a demand for this in the market. So we go out and we test this because we just want to help you and want to make sure that you've got the right tested applications. So the diameter 250 millimeter with the wall thickness, that's just a standard HDPE pipe. And you, in this case, because it's again such a large diameter, you will need two multicolor slims, and that's up to 90 minutes again. An HDPE pipe, 125 millimeter through the floor at an elbow. Again, you can see like it's impossible to get a full color around it. And the gap is filled up with multi-mortar. So because it's also like a larger gap actually through the opening, you will need two colors in this case. And that is 60 minutes uncapped, uncapped. So that goes back to this is suitable for rainwater pipes and vented waste pipes that are like open to the outside. Similar with a PVC pipe, this time the pipe is slightly smaller, only 110 millimeters. And therefore we can use just a single multicolor slim, and that is actually 120 minutes uncapped, uncapped. And I think we see this especially a lot in parking garages where you just want your headroom to be as high as possible. So you have them as close as possible actually to the soffit, these pipes. So we've got now solutions for these for 2 hours. This is also brand new, where we've tested the rectangular ventilation ducts. These are like the standard sizes of these ventilation ducts. And with a single multicolor slim, when it's very tight against the soffit, we can achieve fire ratings up to 2 hours. And also we've tested it through a wall penetration itself that with a slightly different size. But again, these are both standard sizes that we've used for these tests. Some flue gas pipes, flexible steel gas pipes, apologies for this. We've tested them both directly through a floor, but also with the coated board, because quite often you will find it's actually just a large opening that's been left for the services to have more flexibility on site. And so we've tested it with like a coated board as well. And here you can see actually it's tested in combination with one of our other wonderful products, the multi-term bandage, to make sure that there's not too much heat transfer on top of the floor neither. This is a pneumatic tube through a rigid floor that we've tested recently as well. I'm not 100% sure how often this is used, but we've got it as well, tested uncapped, uncapped, even with a conduit at the side as well. And some soft drink tubes, these are called Python tubes, where we've got like a combination of these tubes through one opening with insulation around it as well. And as long as there's less than 52 or less pipes going through, so the diameter is less than 145, this has been tested up to 2 hours. And again, we've tested it as well through our coated board system, the Multimastic C system. Now here I've got a few photos of some tests that we've done. All our tests are done towards the European BSEN 1366 part 3. And that means we test in flexible walls, because that is a worst case scenario compared to a concrete wall, with a width of 100 millimeter thickness. And it's got two fire line boards on each side of the wall. This is like a standard buildup for these kinds of tests in the norm 1366 part 3. What else you can see in the picture is like the thermocouples, which measure the temperature, and the maximum temperature for the criteria of your compartmentation is a difference of 180 degrees. So all these little white dots measure are the thermocouples, which measure the temperature. Now you can see little white caps on the pipes, and these are the capped pipes. So they are open inside the furnace, but they are kept outside the furnace. So yes, you guessed it already correctly. The other ones are uncapped, and that are the ones that are being used for rainwater pipes and vented waste pipes. As you can see as well, is we've got some pipes at an angle, but also different types of pipes. You can see probably different colors of the pipes, different diameters as well, trying to have as many applications tested as possible. This is also just before a test. You can see three different types of pipes going through one opening with one color around it. The seal between, in this case, the plasterboard and the pipes is sealed up with either multi-mastic SP or multi-sealant A. And you can see there, it's like an acoustic insulation as well that's tested around. So all tested with one multicolor slim. Now, this is when there's action in the fire. You can actually see the fire because it's an open pipe. And of course the smoke you can see here, but normally you wouldn't see it because the pipe would be continuously going throughout the building. But you can't have a continuous pipe all the way going meters and meters in a test lab. So this is like standard how it's being tested. Now, this is where you've got an open, uncapped pipe scenario. Because of the overpressure in the furnace, it actually blows out some of the inlay from the multicolor slim. And so, but there's enough multicolor slim inlay within the color itself to create a good seal on the pipe. And, but this is also why sometimes you can't use graphite for an uncapped scenario, because it would you blow all the graphite out before it's got a chance to create a good solid seal and give you your compartmentation. So the little black grayish bits are the inlay of the pipe during the test. Now this is after the test from the side of the furnace. You can see like all the pipes have melted away apart from the metal one. And you can see like some pipes might be open because they might have been 60 or 90 minutes, and we always will test to at least 2 hours. But here you can see the pipes that have achieved a full 2 hour fire rating without any problem. The seal is still there even after 2 hours. Again, the multicolor slim has done its work perfectly. It sealed up the complete gap where once used to be a pipe. And that's exactly what you want. And similar for a color fixed onto a coated board, onto our coated board, a multi-mastic C. So you can see here the pigtail screw still holding the color into place as well. Well, I've come now pretty much to the end of this webinar. So already, thank you very much for your attention. Now, I mentioned earlier in the webinar a few times, you can always look at the multi-selector. This is one of our digital tools. We also have a data manager that you can see slightly left of that, and a project manager. The data manager for recording your fire stopping on site. So the multi-selector you can find on a PC, but also on any mobile device on an app. So even on the go, you can find your tested solution that you might need for your applications on site. I hope you found this webinar of interest to you, and I hope you will be able to use a lot of it on your next applications or the applications you might be working on at the moment. So thank you very much for your attention. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact us, no problem at all. I'm happy to either contact you back on phone or on email. So thank you very much.